Students, today we are going to see unit number 3. From unit number 3, 3.3, that is soil erosion. If we see the definition of soil erosion, it is the detachment, transport and deposition of soil particle on land surface termed as loss of soil, measured as mass per unit area, ton per hectare or kilogram per square meter. Or soil is also defined, soil erosion is also defined as it is a natural process and removes soil from one location to another. It becomes a problem when human activity causes it to occur much faster than under natural conditions. Also, soil erosion is defined as it is the washing or blowing away of the top layer of the soil. Erosion, whether it is by water, wind or tillage, involve three distinct actions, that is soil detachment, movement and deposition. Now, different types of soil erosion. First is the geological erosion. It occurs under normal natural conditions by itself, without the interference of man. It is very slow process. The second type of soil erosion is the accelerated erosion. This is the most serious type of loss, generally caused by an interference of any agencies like man and animals. It is a rapid process. Then, accelerated erosion is again divided into different types like wind erosion, water erosion. Water erosion is also of different types, like raindrop erosion, soil rill erosion, gully erosion, bank erosion, sheet erosion, landslide erosion, and the last is the landslide erosion. So, it is the normal process. Geological erosion is a normal process representing erosion of land in natural environment. It is caused by effect of rainfall, runoff, wind, topography, atmospheric temperature. Accelerated erosion is due to man-made activities which have brought about changes in natural cover and soil condition. The activities includes land preparation for raising crops, land use patterns for building houses, infrastructures, industries, hill cutting, deforestation, lack of soil conservation and watershed management. Water erosion. The impact of raindrops causes splash erosion. Run of water causes scoring, scraping and transport of soil particles, leading to sheet, rill and gully erosion. Flood water causes erosion of river banks. Water waves cause erosion of bank and sides of reservoir, lakes and oceans. Subsurface seepage water causes soil boiling, erosion and removal by piping. Glacial erosion causes heavy landslide. Here, this is the soil erosion by water. Wind erosion. It is primarily responsible for creation and maintenance of desert areas. Finer soil particles from topsoil along with organic matter and nutrients are easily detachable and removed by wind velocity. In this image, you can see how there is a wind erosion. This is the erosion due to surface water runoff. The soil is moving along with that running water. This is the bank erosion. Due to water, the soil from the bank, it is eroded. We can see in this image. This is the sheet erosion. Sheet erosion is the movement of soil from raindrops, splash and runoff water. It is typically occurs evenly over a uniform slope and goes unnoticed until most of the productive topsoil has been lost. Here the upper layer of that soil, it is removed. Next is the rill erosion. In general, the sheet flow is carried out by very small definable channels called interrills. When the process of soil erosion and deposition through interrill is prolonged, the interrill are widened, leading to formation of small channels called rills. Here in this image you can see there is formation of the rills in that land. Gully erosion. Rills are smaller in size and depth. They can be destroyed by tillage operation. If their occurrence is prolonged, rill become larger in size and cannot be destroyed by tillage operation, and they become gullies. Here you can see how the rills they got converted into gullies. Now, problems of erosion. The first problem, that is the loss in agricultural production. Then loss of nutrients from soil, reduction of infiltration rates, increased cost in tillage operation, flood may occur in rivers, decrease in useful life of reservoir, survival of wildlife, land degradation, cost of removal of sedimentation and desertification. These are the different problems which are occurring due to the soil erosion. How we can conserve the soil? So, soil conservation is a set of management strategies for prevention of soil being eroded from the earth surface or becoming chemically altered by overuse, acidification and the salinization. Soil erosion or other chemical soil contamination to retain the fertility of soil. The different methods for soil conservation. The first is the cover crop. Cover crop are close growing crop that provide soil protection, seeding protection and soil improvement between periods of normal crop production. Use of mixed cover crop including grasses and legumes increases the biomass return to the soil and enhances activity of soil organism and improves soil productivity. So what are the advantages of this cover crop? First is it protects soil against erosion, it improves soil properties, enhances soil fertility, suppressing weeds. Then nitrogen fixing is also good in such type of cover crop method. It increases the soil organic matter content, it increases crop yield, recycling of nutrient occurs, it prevents leaching of nutrients and it improves water quality. The next method of soil conservation is the terrace farming. Terracing is one of the very good method of soil conservation. In terrace farming, make or form into a number of level flat areas resembling a series of steps. So the crops which can be cultivated by using such type of terrace farming are the rice, cotton, sugarcane, wheat, potatoes, and this is the very popular method in Eastern Asia. What are the advantages for this terrace farming? It reduces erosion. Contour farming effectively reduces rate of erosion in soil with slopes of up to 10%. It holds rainwater, which allows for the cultivation of water intensive crops as mentioned before. Farmers use this technique because it allows for the cultivation of water intensive crop in these areas because it helps trap and hold rainwater. The third method, contour plowing. This practice of farming across the slopes takes into account the slope gradient and the elevation of soil across the slope. It is the method of tilling sloped land in order to conserve rainwater, and with the help of furrows, crop rows and wheel tracks across the slopes. This method helps in slowing the water runoff and prevents the soil from being washed away along the slope. Crops which are the crops which can be taken or which can be cultivated in such type of method is the corn, beans or wheat. Advantages of this method: that it reduces erosion and runoff, it helps preserve top soil and the minerals, fertilizers used for growing the crops, farmers use it because it protects crop from violent storms or heavy rains and preserve top soil. The next method is the crop rotation. Crop rotation is the practice of growing a series of dissimilar types of crop in the same area in sequential seasons. Continuous cultivation of the same crop also leads to an imbalance in the fertility demands of the soil. To prevent these adverse effects from taking place, crop rotation is practiced. It is a method of growing a series of dissimilar crops in an area sequentially, planting three or more different crops before returning to the original crop constitutes long-term rotations. The advantages of this crop rotation are: reduce soil erosion, it improves soil properties, it increases organic matter content, and it improves soil fertility. Here some questions are given, some three MCQs are given, then definition and short answers. You have to write the short answers for the questions. Okay, thank you.